Hello, I'm Rob with ScrappyDew.com, and in this tutorial we're going to be going over the soft focus effect in Photoshop. Now, the soft focus effect is a pretty cool effect that you can use in photography. Now, if you're old enough, you can probably remember the glamour shots. That's sort of what we're talking about, the soft focus effect, maybe a wedding photo and such. Now, you can normally achieve these soft focus effects in special lenses that you have for cameras, or possibly a modern camera that already has these settings built in will have this soft focus effect as well. Now, if any of the cases that I've mentioned above that you do not have or is unavailable to you, you can easily create this in Photoshop or GIMP or Photoshop Elements. All right, so I'm going to open up this photo in Photoshop, and I got this image from simplyperfectionkicks.com if you'd like to follow along. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and duplicate this layer, and you can do this by going to Control-J or Command-J on the Mac. Next, we're going to go ahead and select that layer that we just created, and we're going to go up to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and we're going to go play along with this little radius slider here. Now, the actual amount of blur that you are going to use will vary from photo to photo. Now, what you're looking for here is a type of blur that will be evident, but does not take away the details of the photo. Now, you can pretty much ignore all the close-up shots that are currently blurry because we're going to be taking care of them in the upcoming steps. So, all right, so once you're satisfied with the amount of blur that you have, you can go ahead and hit the OK button. Now, once you do that, we want to make sure that you are still selected that top layer, the blurry layer, as your active layer, and we want to go ahead and alter the opacity. Now, you'll have to experiment with the opacity because there's no magic number to use. So I would say stay between 50 and around 85. And if you find yourself going below 50, you may want to choose a different image, or you may want to change the effect that you're trying to go for with this soft focus effect. All right, so far so good. Things are already looking nice and everything seems set. However, there are a couple small things that you may need to look at before you're ready to send this piece to print. All right, so with the blurred layer still active, we want to add a layer mask by clicking the Add Layer Mask button in the Layers palette. Then we're going to go ahead and grab a brush tool, and we want to choose a round brush with feathered edges. We also want to make sure that the hardness slider is set all the way down to zero. Now, making sure that the layer mask is still selected, indicated by the rectangle around the mask, you will, with a black paintbrush, go ahead and start painting over the areas. In this case, we're going to be painting over the cupcakes that we want to not be blurry. Now, as you paint, you'll notice that details will start appearing, and that comes from the layer underneath. Now, you can think of this as everything that you paint black will be transparent so that the underneath layer will be showing through. Now, as a side note here, if you do not have the black color as your active color as the foreground, you can hit the D button on the keyboard and it should change the black to the foreground. Also, if you make a mistake by coloring something black that should have been white, you can go ahead and just swap your colors and then repaint with the white brush and it will bring the blurriness back. Alright, so we're almost done. Now, as a final touch, you can go ahead and bump up the saturation a bit by hitting the Control-U button to bring up the Hue and Saturation dialog box. Now, you can go ahead and play around with the saturation slider. You know, you can move it to the right, move it to the left, just to make those colors pop. And it's totally up to you on how much saturation that you would like to use. So with that done, the photo is now ready. Now, while I can only show you one application of the soft focus effect, you can see that it can be used with a variety of photos. Now, I hope you're able to follow along okay, and if you have something to add on how you create the soft focus effect, please list your comments and ideas below. With that, I'm Rob with ScrappyDew.com, and I will see you next time. Thank you.